So there's been a lot of controversy lately about why drugs are so expensive.
This prescription is too high.
Total drug spending jumped last year by 3% to nearly $330 billion with a B.
What these guys do is so outrageous.
Most recently, big pharma company Gilead Sciences came under fire for charging $85,000 for its hepatitis C treatment.
Okay, now a lot of people think the reason drugs cost so much is because pharmaceutical companies are greedy and they know that you'll pay anything to stay alive and be healthy, and so they charge as much as they possibly can. Well, that's part of the story, but it's definitely not all the story. See, drugs cost so much because drug development is expensive and hardly anyone is willing to help. It kind of reminds me of the story of the little red hen. So for the sake of the story, let's say that the pharmaceutical companies are the little red hen. We'll call her the little red pharmaceutical company. So the little red pharmaceutical company wanted to develop a cure for cancer. First, she needed to test some chemicals to see their effects on cells. Wow, hey guys, look at this research. This chemical family might hold the cure for cancer. Let's test all 10,000 chemicals in the family and see if one of them works.
Sounds great,
said the government.
Yay, drugs,
said the patients.
Nice work,
said the charities. But wow, this testing is gonna cost a lot of money. Who will help me do this testing?
Not I,
said the government.
Not I,
said the patients.
Not I,
said the charities. Fine, I'll dig into my savings and pay for it myself, said the little red pharmaceutical company, who went and got some private investors and tested all those drugs. And she found one that was very promising. Hey guys, I wanna take this drug to clinical trials, said the little red pharmaceutical company. But it's very expensive to recruit all those patients in a 3-phase study. Who will help me?
Not I,
said the government.
Not I,
said the patients.
Not I,
said the charities. Okay, fine, I'll do it myself, she said. So the little red pharmaceutical company got some more private investors and ran 3 rounds of clinical trials. And she found one drug that was very promising. Oh my gosh, this drug is very promising. Now I need to get it approved by the FDA. But doing the submissions is very expensive. Who will help me? Asked the little red pharmaceutical company.
Not I,
said the government.
Not I,
said the patients.
Not I,
said the charities. Okay, fine, I'll do it myself. So the little red pharmaceutical company got some more private investors and she got her drug approved. Wow, now I have the cure for cancer. Who would like some? She asked.
I would like some, and it should be cheap, because I don't have much money,
said the government.
I would like some, and you better give it to me, otherwise I'm going to die,
said the patients.
I would like some, and I'm a charity, so you should give it to me for free.
No, said the little red pharmaceutical company. F*** you guys. I spent billions of dollars and 10 years developing this drug. I won big when all my other pharmaceutical company friends went out of business. I'm gonna charge you as much as I possibly can. And the government, the patients, and the charities complained a lot.
So who's to blame when pharmaceutical companies want a lot of money for the drugs that they've developed? The public often sees charging a big price for saving one's life as immoral, but is it?
Well, pharmaceutical companies have to pay the bills like anyone else, and it costs around $1 billion to get a drug all the way to the marketplace. It's super risky, and there's a very high chance of failure and bankruptcy. So if you're gonna take on all that risk, you damn well wanna see a reward. But the actual problem is not that the drug companies are doing too much expensive R&D work. The problem is that they're not doing enough of it. With pharma companies, a lot of the people in suits see drug research and development as a waste of shareholders' money. And so if drug companies put their shareholders first, that means they should be shutting down labs, firing scientists, and paying bigger dividends.
And this is what is actually happening. In the last 5 years, 14,000 people have been fired from the 11 biggest drug companies.
If pharmaceutical companies are going to keep gambling on drug research and development in a quest to find effective treatments, they need to have the promise of a big profit. And this is why they've continued to invest in Alzheimer's disease when 99.6 of the 411 clinical trials have failed. It's because they know that someone out there is going to win big, and so they keep gambling. If we make the prize smaller by enforcing low prices for new drugs, these companies will just stop gambling. And that means that the patients are ultimately the losers because no new treatments are going to be researched or developed. So the government could take on the role of drug development. And right now they sometimes sometimes do help out financially. The NIH fund a lot of the original research into what drugs would be promising cures. But getting those promising cures through the drug development phase has always been done by private investment. So if the government wanted to invest billions of dollars in taking promising drugs through the drug development phase, through clinical trials and to market, that would be possible. But it would take billions of dollars of public taxpayer investment. So whilst drugs would be owned by the government when they were finally developed and therefore be able to be free for citizens, it also means that we'd have to find a whole bunch of new taxpayer dollars, and that money ultimately comes from the public. So whether or not the government should be investing more in drug development is kind of open for debate.
But what do you guys think? Do you think that drug companies are greedy, or that they should serve patients better? Or do you wish that the government would pick up more of the tab when it comes to drug development? Let us know in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching ScIQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.